Welcome back to the channel. So in this video we'll be focusing on voice and video calling service. So we'll be using VoxImplant, which I've just put it here. Let me just show you. I'm just here to get you started. So just go into VoxImplant, sign up for the service, it's free. And then just get into the login screen and sign in. Now just go ahead and create a scenario. I've just named it HumDum and create a script like this and just save it. Let me just zoom in so it will be easier for you to look at. Vox engine dot play sound and hang up, and I've used the default hello. And save it. Now what we want to do is, so we want to create users. So this is some demo users I have created, and we want to create these users from within our app and link it with the applications right here, where I believe you have to assign that rules which we have used here. Now what VoximPlant allows us is this HTTP API, which we'll be using as async storage, which I have defined in the previous video. And let's see one of its ideas, where this will be the email which you just registered with and your password, and it gives you the JSON response of account email, account ID, API key, account name, which will be used for accessing these applications, for adding an application, and then for the users to be created like this, and deleting the user and binding the user into the application, which we have done it. Now let's start building the app. I have just cloned my repo, and this is the previous build which I have used for sign in and sign up screen. So I've already installed this React navigation, that stack navigator. Now what I need to do is I need to npm install this loading spinner and VoxImplant. Loading spinner will be used when we are accessing this HTTP API, and VoxImplant will be our video. So let me just copy all of this. So I've just installed all of this. You can see it right here. Npm install loading spinner and VoxImplant, and then linked it. So I know some of you might be facing some problems. So I advise you, if your version and my version are matching, so just check it. And then don't forget to link it, as there will be minor changes right here. So it must be importing VoxImplant and spinner. So let's have a look at layout. I've added this working PNG file. So for in app.js, there will be component did mount. So as soon as the page loads, this will be executed, where it checks if there is a variable named email local stored. If yes, set email as true. No, set email as false. So let's check it. So we have imported this device event emitter, which will be coming back later on. And we have imported this VoxImplant in app.js. And so in component did mount, check if there is a variable named email local stored. So
component is mount, we'll be getting email item, and if item is there, then set email A as true, which we have defined as false right here, and then voximplant.stk.connect. So try the stk connect to set page as login after connection listener. So as we have done it, this stk.connect will load this device emitter event and add listener for connection successful, and it will go to console.log as connection successful and set the state of page as login. So these are some of the device emitter events that are being used by VoxImplant, and we are using majorly three, which are connection successful, login successful, and login failed. And we have just come up to there, and then let's check in. So we have already finished this section and we have gone to render. So if not, this the state.email, that is no, which probably will be only if in post launch, that is the user hasn't logged in, then we'll be navigated to login.js, and if state.page.login is true, then we'll be navigating to here, which will be coming later on. So let's go to login.js.
So just like in app.js, we have added this device event emitter, which we may change as we may need this different, but I have just commented out as I don't have much changes right here. And I have imported this spinner, and let's check here. STK connect for listener as connection success. So it will be following the same step, STK.connect, and then we will be going to render. In render, if forget password touch of touchable opacity, then we haven't defined anything. But in case of login, icon and login text input and set values. So we have already set these values, and I have covered it in previous video. And on login trace, which is right here. So let me just go to definition. And in this state, we have put login true. Let me just show you the spinner. EINNER. So the spinner is visible only in the case this touch state.loading. So as we have defined it as true, then the spinner is going to be shown. And in this state, we have stored email and password. And here comes the major section, which will be account name value and app name value. So account name value will be your account name, which mine was ARYAMINUS, and I think I have defined it as Humdum. And then const username, where this one is going to extract my email. So if my email is sunim.54@gmail.com, it will be extracting sunim.54, and then it will be showing you this username value so you can check it. And then the password value is password, which we have got it from here. And then stk.login, which will be match in here, which we'll cover later on. So it will be getting this username value, app name value, account name value, and password value from here. And then console log it, then set the spinner as false, so let it say done, and then navigate to boiler. So we'll be following this part. You can refer it for your own preference. And in the next case, we'll be looking towards here, where if sign up touchable opacity will be clicked. Now this login only works if for this account name value there is already a predefined app name value, that is Humdum, and it already has that application, a user which we are going to log in with, that is in AWS in applications. So if you are using Omnum, which is right here, and let's see the assigned users. So only the users which are right here, it can access or log in, and the other users cannot log in. So in the next video, we'll be talking about how to create a user and then bind it in the applications, or create a new application and then bind the user.
Now, as the video is getting quite long, I will show you this register navigation that is on sign up protocol opacity in the next video.